All right, so it is day two. We are at Kobe Swap Meet. It's foggy, but the filter is great. So I'll take the foggy filter. We got Debi.
I look 25 right now.
I know, nobody's gonna call me your daughter today. We are so excited to be junking. So we'll take you along, we're gonna show you what we find, but then we're also gonna be doing some painting today.
Oh yes.
So we're gonna take you to Debbie's shop later. Here we go. So it's pretty sparse because it's raining, like a mist. It's not even like real rain. I don't know what this is. But we're gonna check out some booths and maybe we'll have to go thrifting. Debi really wants to buy this. I just want you to show you the style of DIY Agogo right here. All right, so lots of good stuff here is worth walking over for. We purchased these three rolling pins, $10 for three, $3 for this cute little rocking horse, but Debi is buying all the junk, man. Look at this, so much good stuff.
Good rusty stuff right here.
Debbie's making the deal. So I really want that pitcher. He said 20, I offered 10, I'm gonna try 15. We have success, $15. It's got the braided handle from Denmark. I love it. 15.
Like that's too big to sell. I would put flowers in that and use it for staging. I love that.
So pretty.
It's from Denmark, right?
Yeah. All right, so not taking these home, but loving these arrangements. If I lived in California, I would be doing succulents and all the things. Look how cute that is. All right, so I found this bag. It had all this brass in it and then all of these IKEA candlesticks, and I asked her how much for all the brass. $10 for all of this brass. Super excited to get this into the shop and stage it up cute.
$10, all the brass I can carry.
That's awesome.
I'm excited.
Are you gonna paint?
No.
We don't paint the brass.
We don't paint, it's a nice piece of brass.
What are you doing?
So Zeb was smart and brought his raincoat because apparently sunny California is now the Pacific Northwest.
Yeah, it does feel a lot like Washington, about the same temperature too.
Yeah, it is so wet here, holy moly. So not as much junk as we'd been hoping for at the swap meet. So Zeb said, let's go to Consignment Classics. And Debbie's like,
it was Debbie's idea, but I feel like walking up to this place, it's gonna be more like an indoor swap meet.
Yeah, it might be more than we wanna pay, but fun to look at stuff.
So here is a booth after my own heart, like all the cottage floral, so cute, not at a price that I feel like is affordable for me, but I can definitely appreciate the eye candy, especially all the flow blue is just really gorgeous in here.
Okay, not like the swap meet, very organized, neat, priced. Similar boat. It was $50 at the swap meet. This one is $229. Across the street. It just keeps going.
Look at all the copper. It's so good. That's pretty. How much is that?
$29.
Oh, that's too much.
Yep.
So I'm gonna go ahead and film this because I love this little arch and it does good to give you area to hang stuff. And maybe we could do something like this in the church. What do you guys think? Would it take it away or would it make it better? Zeb?
I think Zeb. It will make it better and you still see the ceiling up above.
Yeah, it's good.
Like you can see that ceiling.
Yeah, but nobody wants to see that ceiling.
Pretty cool.
This box is like wicked sweet.
That is awesome.
Not for $29, but still cute.
It's broken a little.
This angel is really cool. It would totally be fun to paint.
I love that it's solid. Like yeah. A lot of times these are hollow, but this is a solid piece.
Yeah, but it's probably not coming home with us for $349.
Yeah.
I love all the dishes, but the thing is, like, at least for me, like, I don't sell whole dish sets. I sell, like, a plate or a soup tureen because people want, like, mix and match. I don't know. Comment. Do you guys think people are still doing whole sets? Or do you think people do, like, more pieces here and there? I actually really do love this set. I think that's beautiful. But it's just not what we sell anymore. We sell a piece here and there, so we don't really buy whole sets. Look who I found. My good friend Missy Paints the World. Missy, don't be mad. I might have rearranged a few things because it looks like you've sold out a lot of stuff, so I just moved it up because your stuff is so cute. I love this. That's darling. I might be copying that idea. Just saying. So I didn't think I would take anything home, but I have purchased these in Europe. We sell them for around $125. This one is in tremendous shape. It's got the lion head, the beautiful porcelain knobs. They're not even broken. Like, I think this one might be even somewhere close to like $130, maybe $140, because it's in such good condition. And they only want $20. So never be afraid to come to antique malls to get ideas and also pick up maybe what somebody else doesn't value as much as you do. This is gorgeous. Teenagers ain't got nothing on this, like the original duck lips right there. And the fake lashes. Like, that doll's got all the things, except for hair. One of my favorite finds today, we finally brought home some angels for Debi. So I bought this today and Debi does not like it, but I think that I can make it a lot better. Always saying how much she loves cherry picks. So I figure if I paint it that color, she's gonna like it, right? Here we go. Okay, so this is just gonna have to dry like this, and Debi promises that she's going to seal it, and then we're gonna put gold wax on all the details. And it's gonna be available for $69.95 on DIY Agogo. I did not show how to do this, but Debi wanted to know stippling and how to build texture. So this is just DIY white swan stippled with a blue color that she mixed, brushed across, and then distressed. And look, it's got yummy texture. And look, there's the guitar that we bought if you watched the other video. Debi, do you love Apothecary?
I love it with this inlay so much. Do you have to seal over this? Because I really love the way it looks now.
I mean, if you never got it wet.
Well, who's going to get a guitar wet?
Might get it greasy.
I don't know. It looks good. It's rose chintz.
If you ate some burgers and fries and then decided to straw.
Yeah, no greasy. Well, you need, you're going to need to seal that too. Can you, if I'm leaving, so you have to promise me you're going to finish it.
How do I, so I can't put wax on it, so what if you heat gunned it? Then could you put wax?
No, I'll seal the front so that way I know that gets done. All right. So I was just really quick and I brushed it lightly and I sealed it up with Big Top. So I'm going to leave it like this. Hopefully Debi gets it finished because we're going to dinner. All right, Debi, you survived the weekend with us.
I had so much fun.
It was good. We're headed. Look at that sunshine, guys.
I know. What's finally going on?
California is showing off before we go to the frozen tundra of Utah. It's been great. Thanks for junking along with us. And
when are you guys coming back?
When should we come back and visit Debi?
Oh, that's up in the air. We'll see.
Hopefully in a few months.
Yes.
For the paint and products used here today, visit jamierayvintage.com.